Hi everyone, welcome to Ms. Du's algebra and pre-algebra classes. This video is about the rules and routines of my classroom specifically to help make it a wonderful year. If you would right now, please get out your flipped notebook so that you can take notes following the WISC model that we talked about in class. You will summarize this video and also jot down a couple questions, so please do that now. The rules of my classroom are the same as the rules for our school, following TFMS, Turkey Foot Middle School, but these letters also stand for something else. I believe that these rules cover it all, whether it's you're in the building, in the whole school, in other classes, or whether you're in my class. I believe these rules just cover everything that you should do. Right now, if you would, pause the video and jot down what the TFMS stands for as far as the rules for our school. Now for the routines of my classroom, the grading policy. Well, the purpose of grades is to provide an accurate description of how well students are learning the standards. I will really work this year to show grades that reflect what you know as far as mathematics. I will not have participation grades. I will not take off for discipline. That doesn't accurately show what you know as far as the standards are concerned. We'll take care of those things in a different way, but it will not reflect in your grade. And I think that's awesome for you because it really gives your parents and yourself, you know, an accurate description of how well you're doing in math so that we can get you some help. We will not use the word homework anymore. Practice is what we will use to describe what you need to complete at home. And that practice or extra practice is due when class starts every day. All work must be shown unless instructions are given otherwise. So for example, if I give you a Pizzazz worksheet, just know that you have to show your work, how you got to the answer, so that I can see how well you're doing and help you in any areas that you need help with. I will not take any work that has any just answers, so I'll just give it back to you and let you complete that until you get that done and you can turn that in. Additionally, please do your own work. Copying answers from a friend or copying the work is cheating and not learning. You will be required to redo these assignments after school. So after all, cheating will not help you master the standards, and if you're not mastering those, we'll give you some extra help on those, but I need to know accurately what you know. Another routine is about the absent policy. Please visit the boogie boards in the back of the room to see what needs to be completed. On those boogie boards will be a form. Please double check the forms and look for your class, either algebra or pre-algebra, to make sure you're looking at the correct assignments. So if you were absent, say on a Monday, please run back to the boogie boards. You'll look on Mondays and you'll see what handouts that were given out or anything that you need to complete in the spring board book. And a lot of times I will also have See Me on there so that you know to come see me and get some special instructions. If I do give anything out in class, like a Pizzazz worksheet or something, any handouts, they'll be located in the file crates by the bookie board, and they will be labeled with the days of the week. So for example, if you were absent on a Tuesday, go back and look at the bookie board. You'll see that I gave out a Pizzazz worksheet, and you'll just look in Tuesday for that worksheet, grab it, and a lot of times you'll just come see me and I'll tell you what you need to do. Also, if you were absent and they're on the day that practice was due, make sure you're turning in your work that you do at home, any practice or extra practice that you do at home, get that turned into me so that I can give you a grade on that. And you'll turn that work in if you're absent in those same crates. They'll be labeled with your period number. So whatever your crate is, and I'll show you that in class, you'll turn that into like period four if you're in the fourth period. When you enter the classroom, please come into the classroom and sit in your assigned seat. We will complete bell ringers most every day. Please get them out when you first enter the classroom and then you can chat. The only people that should be up kind of roaming around are those people who need to get a pencil or sharpen a pencil. When I come into the classroom, I will start the bell ringer right then. So if you're not prepared for that, you might lose some time on completing that bell ringer. So come in and sit down and get that bell ringer out, and then you can chat with your friends. Please make sure you keep a hold of your bell ringer sheets, as I will collect them every Friday. And every Monday you'll get a new sheet, and I'll show you where that will be located so that you can just go grab one every Monday. And also, the bell ringers could be various tasks. Sometimes they could be problems for you to solve, sometimes instructions to set up the class if we're kind of pressed for time. So, but I'll give you those instructions on the board on what you're supposed to do. So if there's a need for you to leave the classroom, please use the restroom before class begins. Restroom breaks given in class will be very rare unless it's an emergency. If you have an emergency, please feel free to come up to me and let me know that. But otherwise, I might ask you to wait till I'm done instructing or something else. So please use that the bathroom before you come into class. You'll be asked to sign in and out should you need to leave the room for any reason during class. That's something new that our team is doing this year. There's a new form that you also must fill out before leaving the room to go to the nurse. That's something that the nurse is requiring now for you to bring that form with you. They will not accept you at the nurse until you have finished that form. So you'll have to have that filled out too. And at the end of the class, please stay in your seat as I will dismiss you. The people outside and the time and the clock doesn't dismiss you. I'll make sure that we're done with what we need to any thoughts I have to finish, and then I'll dismiss you for the day. All right, what to bring? Well, please bring your supplies to class every day, and this includes your flip notebook, any extra paper that you have, and additionally, please do not steal paper from that flip notebook. You're going to need that all the paper you can in that notebook to keep all your summaries and everything in there. So if you steal paper, your flip notebook, you're going to have a lot of notebooks you're going to have to carry around. So don't steal paper from that. Get some extra paper. Bring a calculator every single day. I recommend a TI 83 or 84. Bring your binders with all your handouts that were given out. And additionally, please keep all your work for the quarter. For my algebra students, you need to keep that for the year. You can clean out your binders once a quarter, take them home, put them in a safe place, because you will need that to study for your final exam. You do have a final exam this year. So keep all that, all those handouts and everything, so you have something to study from. And pencils, please make sure you use only pencil in this math class, no pens or anything. If you do, you don't have something to write with, I'll just give it back to you and ask you to redo it in pencil for me. Please bring pencils. I do have some for you, but once they're gone, you're going to have to borrow from a friend. So bring plenty of pencils with you. If you do have mechanical pencils, please make sure you're bringing lead, so that you have lead for your pencils. Otherwise, bring two or three mechanical pencils with lead in them so that it kind of doesn't break up the learning environment. Technology, I plan on using a lot of technology this year. I want to get into using your cell phones and iPod touches, but I also need to know as soon as possible if you do not, number one, have a working computer at home. That's very important that I know that. So please see me first couple days of school and let me know that you do not have a working computer at home, and also that you might have a working computer, but you might not have internet access. I need to know whether you have either one of those things. So please let me know that right away. And that's it. Let's make it a great year. I'm looking forward to working with you, and I will talk to you later.